Hello there. Let's learn about parts of speech. In that, we shall see about nouns and their types. First and foremost, let us learn what is a noun. A noun is the name of a person, place, animal, thing, or an idea. In person, we would say any person's name or a general category. For example, Raju is a boy. Now, Raju becomes a noun as well as boy is a noun. Similarly, place, Mumbai is a city. Mumbai as well as city become nouns. Animal, all dog, cat, etc. become nouns. Thing, pencil, eraser, these all become nouns. And any idea, that is happiness, joy, sadness, etc. also become nouns. Now we are going on to see what are the different noun types. Take a look at the classification of nouns. If you see here, nouns are broadly classified into two major types, that is noun types and noun modifications. Under noun types, we have four different subtypes, that is general, under which come common noun, proper noun, collective noun. Under objects and ideas come concrete, abstract and material nouns. Under quantifiability come countable and uncountable nouns. And under functions come possessive and adjectival nouns. Now, under noun modifications, we have two types, that is noun gender and noun number. Under noun gender, masculine, feminine, common and neuter. And under noun number, we have singular and plural. However, in this video, we are going to do only about the noun types. Here is a storyboard that has all the different types of nouns that we are going to do today. In this, let's go scene by scene. In the city of Pune lived two children. Hi, I'm Ria and I'm Vinay. The second scene, their mother sent them off to school after breakfast. In the third scene, there's a teacher teaching English. In this, tomorrow we shall visit a farmhouse. Who is this speaking? Miss Jane, their English teacher. And she made an announcement that day. In scene 4, at the farmhouse, Miss Jane and the students were given a warm welcome by Farida and her husband. They were the owners of the place. In the fifth scene, we have Bruno, their dog, who watched over the animals. The green grass and clean air made the place wonderful. Later that day, this happens in the sixth scene. Later that day, Ria and Vinay shared their experiences. Vinay is saying, and there were horses, pigs, oxen. And then Ria said, and also cows, rabbits, sheep, birds. Wow. So you look at this storyboard and try to identify the various nouns in the storyboard. So if you're done with the identification, I'll just put up the list of various nouns in this storyboard. Here. So these are all the nouns that are found in the storyboard. We shall now proceed to categorize the nouns that we have just seen. In that, the first category is the common nouns. If you see all these words, these are not particular things or names of places. These are in general. On the contrary, proper nouns are actual proper names of particular city, person, place, animal, thing, etc. So you see here the difference between common nouns and proper nouns. So let's go on to define them. Thus, common nouns are those names of general class or category of a person, place, animal, thing, or idea. And a proper noun is the name of a particular person, place, animal, or thing. And we have material nouns, which are actually those things which are used to do some object or a thing. For example, silk, stick, bamboo, cotton, etc. Now we move on to the next category of nouns, that is concrete nouns and abstract nouns. If you see here, look at all the concrete nouns. These are very tangible. These are things that you can see, and actually they are present before us. While abstract nouns are those which are you cannot actually see them as any particular thing. So they are not concretely seen. So they are intangible things. So now let's go on to define these two. So concrete nouns are those which is a name of a tangible person, place, animal or thing, and abstract is name of an intangible idea or notion. And here we'll include the collective nouns also, which is a collection of persons, places, animals or things. Well, which is the collective noun in herd of sheep? Herd is the collective noun. Bouquet is a collective noun. A swarm of bees. So swarm is a collective noun. Now we're going to see another category, that is countable and uncountable nouns. So countable are those which you can say 1, 2, 3, 4. You can put a number before them and it makes sense. While uncountable nouns are those wherein you cannot put a number. Even if you put a number, it makes no sense. So you'll say, but then I can say one Ria, two Rias. No, two people with the name Ria. You don't say it is wrong English. Right English does not give number to proper nouns such as Ria, Vinay, Jane. We don't say one India, two Indias, etc. Okay, so this is it. Now we move on to the next category. Before that, we define what is a countable noun, that is name of a person, place, animal, thing or idea that can be counted. And uncountable is a name of a person, place, animal, thing or idea that cannot be counted. Now look at the following sentences. This is a little different. They are Miss Jane's students, and the next one is Miss Jane is an English teacher. Look at what is highlighted. The word Jane is highlighted here. It said Jane's students, but Jane itself is a proper noun. Here we see proper noun is used to indicate possession of the students. Therefore, this becomes a possessive noun. In the second sentence, let's see what is highlighted. The word English is highlighted here, and it is used along with the noun which is teacher. But English itself is a noun. Therefore, you see here, this word is used as an adjective here. Therefore, English remains a noun, but it is called an adjectival noun. In sentence 1, if you see now what we have just described, now what about the contraction Miss, MS, Jane? Now even that is a noun, because any position, doctor, MS, etc., LT for lieutenant, all these things become nouns. So I hope you have understood everything about nouns. Thank you so much for your attention.